I was excited to get this fight over the line, and like you said, I didn't want no tune-ups. I wanted a fight I can get straight back into. So I'm happy this is, you know, this is the fight, and people are excited about it. I'm here to have fun. I enjoy boxing. I ain't putting no unnecessary pressure on myself apart from getting a win.
Where you go? Come on! I told you. I told you before. You gotta listen. Keep going. Keep going. Over. Keep pushing. No, don't stop. The bike. Don't stop. Four above your head.
Five.
Swap it over, now you got the burpees. Ready? Over you go. Yep. Good. Good work.
Getting there, getting closer. Feeling better. So, happy days.
What's happening today?
Today, had 8 rounds of sparring with Ben. Ben Fell, one after the Fell twins, Ben and Carl. Yeah, good fighter. Proper good fighter. Really rate him as well as a southpaw as well. Like, if you're fighting a southpaw, probably the best way you can get from them two. Yeah, he's got a good sense of distance. He's got a good jab. You see his height, he's quite tall and stuff, so he's got good range and stuff, and that probably mimics my next opponent Dignum the best, because Dignum is a bit taller than me, so I think he's the best man for the job right now. Yeah, my coach Martin Bowers, I mean, he's very relaxed, but he has got a edge to him. I mean,
nice and easy start, nice and easy, nice and easy. Make him think though, that doesn't mean fucking do fuck all.
When you upset him, you'd know about it, but he's very relaxed. I'm saying that the spar was going smooth.
So Denzel's attitude for this fight has been really good. Like I said, considering we're coming off of a loss, we've got a lot to prove, as in, I say we, but it's Denzel, obviously.
But it ain't like I'm being horrible, I'm just trying to get him working, you know what I mean?
He had a lot on his mind the last fight. That's making no excuses or taking nothing away from Nathan. I think he turned up excellent and I think he boxed really well.
There it is. Yep, mum, stay there.
Obviously, very disappointing for Denzel. So his attitude has been on point and he's been very focused. He's, you know, he's looking good for this fight.
That's what it's for, isn't it? We're working on things. We're trying to get things off. We've done certain things on the pads that, you know, I was trying to get off in the spar, but I had to also close that distance to get close enough to throw them shots. But with Ben, he's one of them guys, and you get close, he's gonna shoot. So I didn't want to like overcommit to anything and get caught coming in. So I'd be a bit patient. So some things I didn't get to go off, but that all comes to practice, innit? When I start figuring things out, you know, how to get inside, you know, effectively, and how to step off and get certain shots off then we know it's working. But yeah, I mean, I managed to do a few things I'm working on, so he was happy today.
But we've got a real nice squad of boxers. They're all good athletes. They all want to achieve and they're all trying. You can't ask for more. You know, you need a little bit of luck in boxing, which turns into a lot of luck.
He's been really focused on the training camp. We have fun in the gym, but when we spar, we are focused on it and we do what Martin asks us. And I'm really glad to see what is going to happen Saturday. I think he's going to take him out.
Denzel's just a lovely guy, like an all-round guy, a true sportsman, a nice role model in the gym, you know. And he's always helping people achieve what they want to achieve, as well as fulfilling his dream.
Ready? Come on, spiteful. Put him in. Good work, that's spiteful.
He's left no stone unturned. Like, Martin's just like a boxing god, really, you know. He's, what he don't know is not worth knowing. And it's the same thing, like, obviously you can tell that Denzel's been around Martin for many years, because Martin and Denzel are very similar in the way of how to break things down and making things simple, you know. The way Martin breaks it down, the way Denzel breaks it down, it's just so simple. It's like 1 + 1, do you know what I mean? It's just poetry in motion, do you know what I mean?
So yeah, we're in South East London, Greenwich Park. Anyone that knows Greenwich Park is notorious for its hills.
Yeah, midway through the set, so we go one, then we go two, then after the second one, we go round, we go up the stairs, down the hill, up the hill, down the stairs.
So we did 8 kilometres, just an easy jog, which includes 2 long hills, and then we stopped briefly, and then we did 3 sprints up the hill, jogged across, and then 3 sprints up the stairs. So yeah, it's a good run. Very difficult. It's one of them sessions never really gets any easier, but it's necessary work in the bank for me and Denz. Denz is in a good place at the right time, you know. He just had his last spar, so he's looking really good, really sharp, really fresh.
Too sharp in 3 words.
Am I allowed to swear?
Strong.
High pop.
Athlete.
Powerful.
He's a positive person, so positive.
What's that, Munch? He's a gentleman.
He's very caring still, like when everyone's fighting from the gym, doesn't matter who it is, like he's always there, he's always showing up.
Just a G.
Humble.
And mustard, mate. I'm telling you, he is mustard.
And I think he's going to be a great father. He's put the work in, he's done the rounds, he's had some excellent sparring. You know, we've been very fortunate to get some really top-class Southpaw sparring. And that's where we are. We're ready, or he's ready to go, as far as I'm concerned. Weight's good, everything's right.
Well, hello, hello, welcome to London, and welcome to the final press conference ahead of another cracker this Saturday night. British boxing's spiritual home of York Hall, we are back.
You know, I keep saying bounce back, come back, like, it's not that type of fight. This is a real fight, it's a 50-50, you know what I mean? And this is what I asked for. This is a fight I could have had even if I did win my last fight, do you know what I mean? So all of that comeback, bounce back, I get what you don't mean, but this ain't that type of fight. This is a real fight that I'm down for. On Saturday, the good thing about this is we'll both be at the same stage. We both should have peaked. We both should be at our best. So that's when we'll really see, you know, who's better than who. I can't take this lightly, and I'm not taking it lightly, so I'm ready for whatever comes on Saturday.
159 pounds and 1 ounce for Danny Dignum. Now let's welcome to the scales with a record of 18 wins, 3 defeats and 1 draw, with 15 big wins coming by way of knockout. Here's a former 2-time British middleweight champion from Battersea, Denzel SHARPEST Bentley! 158 pounds and 2 ounces for Denzel Bentley. Both fighters make championship weight. The vacant WBO international middleweight title on the line, live on TNT Sports tomorrow.
Dignum, like Bentley, has fought for a world title against the same opponent, very different outcome against the outstanding Alan Cannolly.
They know each other inside out, don't they? So they've done a lot of sparring together, but you know that accounts for nothing when you're in there then, Paul. But you can see what Bentley's doing straight away, staying on the outside. He doesn't want to overcommit that.
And 7 already, and there's damage for Dignum.
Good right hand, wasn't it, Paul, from Denzel Bentley, and he goes again. He seemed to be into the mid-drift, and you can see Danny Dignum straight away trying to bring his elbows down to block that by those body shots. It was certainly a body shot.
That's a great body shot. Might be a finishing body shot. Dignum knows he's got to dig deep indeed here now, and it's very early in the fight. Bentley has shown his teeth, shown he means business, shows he means to put the defeat behind him.
Oh, the
right hand might be a finisher. Down again he goes. John Latham's having a look and starts to count. Eddie Lamb wanted to throw the towel in. Dignum told him not to, but it is called off. It's called off early. Razor sharp tonight. Denzel Bentley. Dignum had no answers. Richie, you were right all along.
Well, super shot, super work there from Bentley with that right hand. I thought that the more patient approach from him, weight on the outside, suited him a little bit better. Danny Dignum seemed to make the mistakes as he sort of poured with that lead hand of his.
I'm on a journey, man.